So we're talking about the lower limb muscles, particular to the leg. And these muscles are very different depending on if you're looking at the anterior portion or the posterior portion. So let's start with the anterior compartment of the leg. And before we get into the actual muscles, I want to talk about how these muscles are very tightly bound within the connective tissue here. So if you have any blood or fluid that's going to escape, it's not going to get very far. It's going to get trapped within the compartment. So if you've ever heard of the term compartment syndrome, typically they're talking about in the specific compartment. So there's three main muscles in this region. I'm not going to have you memorize the particular muscles, but I want you to understand at least the actions that can occur with contraction of these muscles. So importantly, you're going to have dorsiflexion of the ankle. So remember dorsiflexion, those toes are going to be pointing up. Extension of the digits, so those tendons are going to allow for the digits, remember this would be flexion, extension's going to be coming out, so when you're just standing normally. And then inversion of the foot. So in particular, if you're looking here, here is your tibia. All of these anterior compartment muscles are going to be on the lateral side right here. And the largest one right here is your tibialis anterior. Any muscle that starts with tibialis is going to play a role in terms of inversion of the foot. All of these muscles are going to be efferently or motor innervated by the deep fibular nerve. And the deep fibular nerve is going to be a branch of your common fibular nerve. And the common fibular nerve is one of the terminal branches of your sciatic. So, say you do have some type of escape in terms of the fluids that can occur within this area. This can cause for your tibialis anterior to really be smashed down. So that can cause some issues there. Also, if you continuously use your tibialis anterior, this can allow for little micro tears within the muscle that can actually affect the periosteum of the tibia here. So if you've ever heard the term shin splints, it's typically having something to do with your tibialis anterior. Now on the lateral compartment of the leg, these are going to be composed of two muscles, your fibularis longus and brevis. And longus is going to be the more important of the two. And you can see right here, only in this view, you have your fibularis longus. The brevis is going to be deep to this muscle. So this is going to be innervated by the other branch of the common fibular, your superficial fibular nerve. And you can actually see right here in this image, your common fibular and that superficial, the split of the superficial and deep is going to be right underneath your fibularis longus muscle. So, remember, the tibialis muscles are going to play a role in terms of inversion of the foot, so the fibularis muscles are going to be eversion of the foot, so allowing for the sole of the foot to move more laterally. Also, they're going to play a very, very weak role in terms of plantar flexion. All right, so let's move posteriorly now. And you have two compartments associated with the posterior side. You're going to have a superficial, which is what we're looking at here. And this is by far the more substantial and the more important of the two compartments. And you're gonna have a deep, which we'll discuss in just a moment. So the superficial compartment is composed of two muscles, your gastrocnemius or gastrocnemius, you'll hear it either way, and your soleus muscle, which is going to be deep to the gastrocnemius. So you can see here, when you think of your calf muscles, these are the two muscles that you're thinking of. Gastrocnemius is going to be the more superficial, and soleus will be deep to these two muscles, or to this area. Now what's important is, you're going to have these two muscles, they're going to kind of come together in terms of their distal attachment, and they're going to share one tendon, and that's your calcaneal tendon. And we've all heard of your calcaneal tendon referred to as your Achilles tendon. This is the strongest tendon in the body. If you have damage to your calcaneal tendon, that can really play, have devastating effects in terms of being able to plantar flex the foot or even to simply be able to walk, because plantar flexion is going to play a role there. These muscles are going to be innervated by the tibial nerve, which is one of the terminal branches of the sciatic. Plantar flexion, this is hugely important here. So these are the main plantar flexors of the ankle. Also that gastric nemius, if you can see here, and you can see a little bit, you can see that it's extending up past the knee joint region. So it can play a role in terms of flexion of the knee. Now, if you were to reflect these muscles out of the way, then you would be looking at the deep posterior compartment of the leg. Similarly innervated by the tibial nerve, which you can actually see in this visual here. So it kind of sits on top and sends muscular branches to these. These are also going to play a role in terms of plantar flexion of the ankle. However, it is such a minor role that say something did happen in terms of the calcaneal tendon or in terms of just the gastrocnemius muscle or the soleus muscle, these could not compensate for that particular action. Certain muscles within this compartment will also play a role in terms of flexion of the digits, so think about curling your toes, as well as inversion of the foot because you have in here your tibialis posterior muscle. So tibialis, you know we're talking inversion of the foot. So these muscles, as you can see, they're going to extend into the foot, so the tendons are actually extending, so they can play a role in terms of the digits or in terms of the subtalar and transverse tarsal joints.